Eye for an eye, Lloyd. You're messing with my sheep. I think there's gonna be a day of reckoning for you.
Picture over to the left was my great aunt. Tell you what, sit down for a minute, I'll tell you the rest of the story. The oldest son was married and had a child, and the three of them had planned to go into the mission field after the war. Family business kept my great uncle here, and so his wife decided to go on ahead of him. He planned to join her later with the daughter. She disappeared in the woods one day and was never heard from again. He was devastated. They said he was kind of a shell of his former self. Years went by with no word. He would not even tell his daughter that her mother was presumed dead. One day, he walked in on her. She had found in the bedroom her mother's wedding dress and tried it on. He went mad with grief and he smothered her with a pillow. He then went downstairs, hung a belt from a floor joist and hung himself. Before that happened, he had changed the will and left this house as a memorial to his wife to a Methodist mission board to be a place for rest and recuperation for Methodist missionaries, which is why you're here. There are a few rules. He specified in the will there could be no tobacco use here, no alcohol. Ladies have to be in by 10 o'clock when the door's locked. No one is ever allowed to go into the bedroom where the tragedy happened. As far as anything happening, there are stories that the three of them haunt the house. If you believe in ghosts, you might not want to be here.